Phylotaxy is the next important thing that we would take up. So phylotaxy, what does it mean? Phylotaxy. Phylotaxy basically means arrangement of leaves. Arrangement of leaves. And where are these leaves arranged? They can be on a branch or on the stem also. That is the main stem. And why is this arrangement so important? Reason is the leaf should get sufficient oxygen so that they can perform photosynthesis. So there are certain important arrangements which are seen. First is known as alternate arrangement. As the name indicates, every node is going to have only one leaf and the leaves would grow in an alternate manner. Suppose this is the stem and these are all the nodes. Every node would give rise to only one leaf. And suppose the leaf is on this side, on the next node, the leaf is going to be on the other side. That means only one leaf. And why are they alternate? Reason is, this leaf would get sufficient sunlight, this would also get. Now, if we come to this node, again there would be one leaf. But the gap between these two leaves would be enough so that the sunlight can fall on each leaf sufficiently. And the same case would be here. So, this type of arrangement is called alternate arrangement and purpose is for each leaf to get sufficient sunlight. The plants where we see this kind of arrangement, sunflower, China rose, mustard, these are the plants, basically this is one of the most common type of arrangements. The second possibility is called the opposite arrangement. Here, on every node, there would be two leaves. In this case, one leaf on each node. In case of opposite, there would be two leaves at each node. But in case of this opposite arrangement, we find two types of arrangements, further arrangements. They would be opposite, but there is a slight difference. We'll draw the diagram first and then we'll try to give it a name. Suppose, let me draw the stem here and the leaf with green. Suppose this is the stem and these are the nodes. Now, when we draw the leaves, one node has two leaves. These are the two leaves. The next node is also going to have two leaves. The next two are here. The next two, every node is going to have two leaves. So arrangement is that every node has these two leaves. So one node has two, the next one also has two, upper one also has two. So the leaves are arranged one over the other like this. This arrangement is known as superimposed. Now the question arises, would the leaves get enough sunlight because they are placed one over the other like this? Then in that case, in such plants, the gap between two leaves is more. So that again, from here the sunlight falls on this leaf and the sunlight falls on this leaf also. This is seen in case of Eugenia. That is jamun or blackberries. So, in this case, we find this type of arrangement. Every node has two leaves. The second one, now let us see how the arrangement is. Again, every node is going to have two leaves. The first is same as it was a superimpose. Now, on the next node, the upper and the lower, the next pair is going to be at right angles to the first one. That means the leaf is going to be here and at the back side. In this case, again, like this. And here, the leaf is going to be on this side and on the back side. That means arrangement is, first node has like this, the next is going to have like this, then again like this. So, One is like this, the next one is at right angle, then again right angle. Purpose is same, so that each leaf should get sufficient sunlight for photosynthesis. This arrangement is known as decussate type of arrangement. And this is seen in case of osimum, that is tulsi or basil, and it is also seen in case of guava. So these are the plants where we find this kind of arrangement. Both are opposite, but the difference is how the arrangement is at every node. If the leaves are just one above the other on the same plane, then we call it superimposed, and if the pairs shift by 90 degrees, then this arrangement would be called decussate. Third arrangement is known as whorled arrangement. Whorled, as the name tells us, on one node there would be multiple leaves. So if this is the stem and these are the nodes, how would the leaves be arranged? One leaf, second, third is on the back side, then next, next, here. So all these leaves, they are basically on one node. This arrangement is in the form of a complete circular arrangement, which is called the whorled. And here the example is Alstonia. In Alstonia, we find whorled arrangement. So these are three common types of arrangements which are seen, and these arrangements come under phyllotaxy. It is very important, as we said in the beginning, so that each and every leaf gets sufficient sunlight for photosynthesis. Now here we will talk about one more important thing which is associated with this phyllotaxy, and that is known as Skimper-Brown series. Skimper-Brown series. What exactly is meant by this series? The scientists, they found out the arrangements. They said that one circle can have one leaf, or at one node there could be two leaves. So the distance or angle would be 180 degrees. Or there is one more possibility, that one node can have three leaves. So now it is going to become 120 degrees. So now if they analyze, or if we analyze, how is the arrangement? From here, one circle can have two leaves. The second possibility is one circle can have three leaves. They kept studying this arrangement, and they found that when they analyzed or seen two circles, there were five leaves in two circles. They counted one more circle, that means every ring they are counting, every node they are counting. So when we are looking from the top, one ring, second ring, third ring, basically we are counting three nodes. So when they counted three nodes, they found there were eight leaves. So from this number which they got, they came to a conclusion that the next number, if we count one more circle, then the next number can be anticipated or can be assumed on the basis of what is seen here. If we just analyze this, how did we get this? By adding the first two numbers. And here we are simply adding, it is not LCM or anything, not a mathematical addition, it is simple add. So 1 plus 1, 2, 3 plus 2, 5. This is how we got the next number. Let us see this one also. If you want to know how many leaves would be there in 3 circles, 2 plus 1, 3 circles, 5 plus 3, 8. So if we want to know how many leaves would be there in case of if there are 4 circles. So, sorry, if we have to count 5 circles. So 3 plus 2, 5. And we'll have to count these two numbers, that is 8 plus 5. So 8 plus 5 would be 30. Similarly, we can get one more. 5 plus 3, 8 circles if we count, then we will have to add these two numbers. This is how the next number can be calculated. And this series was called Skimper Brown series as, and this series was based on total observation. They kept observing, they came to certain numbers, and on the basis of that, they actually concluded that we can count or find out how the next number is going to be. So on this series, the questions which are asked are very simple. They're going to give you certain numbers and they will ask you what will be the next number. So what we have to do is we have to just add the previous two. Simply add. Not a mathematical calculation or addition by taking LCM or all. Simply add this plus this, this plus this. That is how we get the next number. So phyllotaxy, arrangement, three common arrangements, alternate, opposite and word. And this is a simple series which is known as Skimper Brown series, named after the scientist. So we have seen the structure of leaf, pinnately, palmately compound leaves, the venation also, and phyllotaxy. Now we will have to talk about one more important part that we will discuss in the next video, and that is modifications of leaves. If leaves get modified to perform certain additional functions, that we will take up in the next part.